हेलो क्लास 11, वेलकम बैक। दिस इज द वीडियो नंबर 12 ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 13 फोटोसिंथेसिस इन हायर क्लास। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस वीडियो आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट केल्विन साइकिल व्हिच इज आल्सो नोन एज C3 साइकिल। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट अबाउट C3 साइकिल। स्टूडेंट्स, केल्विन साइकिल इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन द फील्ड ऑफ फोटोसिंथेसिस। इट इज डिवाइडेड इनटू 3 कैटेगरी और वी कैन से दैट 3 पार्ट्स। केल्विन साइकिल इज कैटेगराइज इनटू 3 पार्ट्स। फर्स्ट वन इज कार्बोक्सिलेशन, सेकंड पार्ट इज रिडक्शन एंड थर्ड पार्ट इज रीजनरेशन। आफ्टर द सक्सेसफुल कंप्लीशन ऑफ कार्बोक्सिलेशन, रिडक्शन एंड रीजनरेशन, केल्विन साइकिल इज कंप्लीटेड। एंड व्हाट इज द आउटपुट ऑफ केल्विन साइकिल, व्हाट इज द रिजल्ट ऑफ केल्विन साइकिल। इन माय अर्लियर वीडियो I will told to you about photosynthesis, in which the ultimate goal of photosynthesis is production of glucose and oxygen. So, in the Kelvin cycle, one molecule of glucose is prepared after the 6th turn of this cycle. How this happened? Let's see. Students, in the Kelvin cycle, first of all, RuBP15-biphosphate molecule is react with atmospheric carbon dioxide plus water molecule, and this process is known as carboxylation, where the carbon dioxide is fixed. Carbon dioxide is fixed by RuBP15-biphosphate in the presence of Robisto enzyme, which is the most abundant enzyme of the world, and carboxylation takes place. Carboxylation is the process where atmospheric carbon dioxide is fixed in the cell, in the chloroplast. After the carboxylation, the 3-phosphoglycerate carbon compound is formed. The primary acceptor of CO2 is 3 carbonic compound, that is known as 3-PGA or 3-phosphoglycerate. So after that carboxylation, 3-phosphoglycerate is formed with the help of Robisto enzyme. Then this 3-phosphoglycerate goes to the reduction process, that is the second process of Kelvin cycle, where ATP and NADPH is required, which form the ADP plus inorganic phosphate and NADP. Reduction is the series of chemical reactions, series of process where so many NADP is formed. After that reduction, these molecules go to the triphosphate, where sucrose or starch is formed. Then the third step is regeneration. Regeneration is the step where cycle is again generating RuBP molecules for the next turn of the cycle, and it requires one ATP molecule to form one ADP molecule. So regeneration is the third step of Kelvin cycle, where the RuBP 15-biphosphate is again regenerated and again goes to the atmospheric CO2 for fixation of carboxylation or carbon dioxide. Students, we can say that in the one turn of this cycle, it requires 3 ATP molecule and 2 NADPH molecule for the production of one molecule of glucose. The ultimate goal is production of glucose molecule. So for the production of one molecule of glucose, 3 ATP and 2 NADPH is required in the one turn of the cycle. So the 6th turn of this cycle is necessary for the production of one molecule of glucose, that is known as sucrose or starch. You can see here, enters in the Calvin cycle and how many molecules out from the Calvin cycle. So if in one turn of the cycle 3 ATP is required and 2 MAD pH is required, so if 6 turn of this cycle takes place, so 6 into 3 is equal to 18 ATP and 2 into 6 is equal to 12 MAD pH. So we can write like this: in 6 CO2, here see 1 CO2 in one cycle, so 6 molecule of CO2 in 6 turn of cycle. So when this cycle is turned into 6 time, they use 6 CO2 and gives 1 glucose. They use 18 ATP and gives 18 ADP. They use 12 NADPH and gives 12 NADP. See here, NADPH, it gives NADP. So we can say that one turn of this cycle is required 3 ADP and 2 NADPH for the formation of one molecule of glucose. So finally, the 6th turn of this cycle, this will be result in the 6 CO2 molecule, 18 ATP molecules and 12 NADPH molecules, which gives 1 molecule of glucose. This data is given in your NCERT book also. Students, Calvin cycle is very very important. In Calvin cycle, glucose is formed, sucrose is formed, starch is formed. This is the first visible product of photosynthesis. This is the first product of photosynthesis in the process of Calvin cycle, they form. So we can say that the sucrose or starch is formed by the 3-step process of C3 plant or C3 cycle, that is carboxylation of CO2, reduction of this 3-phosphoglycerate molecule, then regeneration of again RUBP molecules, and after the completion of this, C3 cycle is completed and one molecule of glucose is formed in the process of photosynthesis. So ultimate goal is achieved in the C3 plant, in the C3 pathway. This is known as C3 pathway or C3 cycle, given by Malvin Calvin. After that, in my next video, I will discuss about C4 plant and C4 pathway.